All right.
My name is Faye Emerson, and I've got a broken ankle.
I've Got a Secret, brought to you tonight by Bristol Myers, makers of Buffarin, the modern drug that brings relief from headache pain, protects against stomach discomfort. Bristol Myers brings you America's number one panel show, I've Got a Secret, starring Gary Moore.
Thank you. Good evening. Welcome to what must be obvious to you by now is our Christmas edition of I've Got a Secret. I would like you to meet our Christmas panel. They are Bill Cullen, and then next to Bill, while Betsy Palmer is off on a one-week vacation, is our own Carol Burnett. Next to Carol is Henry Morgan. Next to Henry, Bess Meyerson, and that's our boss. I'm not the active boy I used to be, you know. I get out of breath just running a scooter around the stage. Now, before we begin the festivities, I have a little surprise for the panel and for the audience at large. Last week on our show, we had a young man by the name of Steve DePass who came out on our show and improvised verses to a calypso beat. You might remember that. I hope you were tuned in because seldom have we had such audience reaction. I am not exaggerating when I say that when we got off the air, our switchboard lit up like a Christmas tree. People from all over called in and said, please have him back on your show. So without a secret, but just to receive the applause he so justly deserves, here is Mr. Steve DePass.
Thank you. You killed our audience last week.
Thank you. Thank you.
And you remember the part where you told me that you asked me to get up and sing a verse?
Sure.
I didn't do too well at it.
You did pretty good there. I thought you showed lots of promise.
Lots of promise. All talk and no action. Well, I've been working at this thing now. Do you have your accompanist here?
Richie
Adams?
Yeah.
Hi, Richie. How are you? How the lyrics go to the verse to the vamp again?
Lura, lava, lura, lava,
lava, lava, lava, lava, lava, lava, lava, lava, lava. I start the vamp. Boy, I'll show you how this is done now. Lava, 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 lie. 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 Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Steve DePass. You remember him from last week, I trust. He broke up the show with his singing rhymes, so we brought him back here one more time. Tell me, tell me, tell me, since last week, what has happened to you? I want you to tell me quick. As for my singing on this Christmas, I guess I won't put you out of business. Reaction to my singing. Ad-lib this is. Completely ad-lib.
Well, your singing fills my heart with gaiety. I have never seen such spontaneity. But the thing that holds me spellbound and in a trance is not your singing, Gary, but your dance.
Carol Burnett, just suggest any subject. You were the only one who didn't get to try last week because you weren't here. Any subject at all?
Women on diets.
Women on diets.
Well, Carol, I'm most happy to try it. But why are you concerned about a woman on a diet? Anyone looking at you sees you're expressly trim. My goodness, how do you manage to stay so slim? I bet you're one that could tell all how in life to truly have a ball, to stay slim and gay and be a riot like you are every Tuesday night. Don't you deny it. Lava, 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 no.
Steve, I got a special Christmas present for you. I hope you will consider it a special present.
Please. Really?
Yes?
Oh, I thought I was going to get the scooter.
No, no. You can have that, too. This is an envelope, which when you open it up backstage, you will find contains a contract for our Tuesday night show
And we're looking forward to having you a guest as soon as we can possibly arrange.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Open the big city.
Lava, 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 lo. Jerry? Lava, 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 lo.
You know, he's a fine straight singer, too, in addition to all the gimmicks and the tricks. Now, may we have our first contestant, please? Come in.
Nice to see you. Just go over and be seated, if you will. Good evening.
Nice to see you, Roberta.
How are you? Dad? I say, how are you?
Now, we'll all be seated. We'll try to sort out for the audience just who we are and where we're from. And we'll start with this married couple to my right. What are your names? Please.
Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Rigger, Miami Beach, Florida.
Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Rigger from Miami. And this couple?
Mr. and Mrs. Pat Rigger from Brooklyn.
Mr. and Mrs. Pat Rigger. Pat Rigger is the son of Joseph Rigger. And the young lady?
Roberta Rigger from Brooklyn.
Miss Roberta Rigger. And she is the daughter of the Pat Riggers. So we have here three generations of Riggers. Now, they have, each has a different secret, but very similar and interrelated, as are they. So I'm going to ask you, first of all, to whisper your secret to me, please. And that's the Joseph Riggers. Now, the Pat Riggers. And the third generation, Miss Roberta Rigger. All right, now, panel, this concerns something that is going to happen. As I say, the secrets are not identical, but they are similar, and there is a thread of connection between them. Let's start the questioning, please, with Bill Cullen.
You say they're similar, and there's a thread of connection between them. Are you all going to take part in, like, one event?
Yes, they will each take part in an event.
Can we call it a performance?
No.
No, I don't think so, Roberta.
Roberta said yes.
Well, I think if she's going to stand for a little correction for me, it's not really a performance. In the sense that it's for entertainment. It's not an entertainment.
It's going to be done here tonight, though.
No.
Oh, no. Oh, dear, that blows my whole theory. It's going to be done sometime between now and the holidays.
Yes. Between now and Christmas Day.
All right.
$20 down, $60 to go. We go, please, to Carol Burnett.
Is this something directly connected with the holidays, with Christmas?
No. Not really. The fact that it is happening at this Christmas time is the only connection.
But it's only because
really
they're all getting together. You say, in a sense, it is performing something?
In a sense, it is not. No, it is in no sense a performance.
Is it something physical that you do?
Well, yes, there's a certain amount of physical action involved. However, the overall action is certainly mental and...
Could I do this?
Could you do this? Yeah.
Could I?
All right, $40 down, $40 to go. Let me go, please, now to Henry Morgan.
Well, dear me, I hate to be rude to guests, but I've seen Carol work, and I'd rather see her do it.
What it is.
Any idea? I don't know. Is what you're going to do sort of funny?
No.
Happy, but not funny.
Happy. Are there other people going to show up when you do what you do?
Yeah.
Are they related to you?
Some of the other people will no doubt be related to you, those who show up. All right, $60 down, $20 to go. We go to Bess Meyerson, please.
Well, Roberta, is it going to happen specifically to you rather than to the other people present? Yeah. And is what is going to take place, did it happen similarly to you, Mrs. Pat Rigger, and you, Mrs. John? Are you getting married, like, on Christmas Eve or something like that? Yes?
Yes, and the same thing happened.
And they all did?
The Joseph Riggers, this coming Christmas Eve, will celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary, which is just marvelous.
Golden.
And the Pat Riggers, on this coming Christmas Eve, will celebrate their 25th anniversary.
Silver wedding.
Silver wedding, yes. And Roberta here, what is your secret? What's going to happen to you on Christmas Eve?
Getting married.
She's getting married. This will be the third generation of riggers to have their wedding on Christmas Eve. I know you're anxious to meet her fiancé. I'd like to see or hear about his aspect of the whole thing. Martin Plofter, would you join us down here, please?
Did you know about this ritual when you and Roberta got engaged?
Yes, I did.
I guess you're happy to be part of this tradition,
yes,
huh?
Yes, very.
Well, now you stay right where you are, because we have, this being the golden anniversary, for you, Mrs. Joseph Rigger and Mr. Joseph Rigger, a little golden present from us, which you can open backstage. For you and your husband, a silver anniversary gift from us. Now, as I understand it, Martin and Roberta, you all were going to drive a car down to Miami. Was that the idea? Well, for your honeymoon, huh? Well, the reason that you're driving all the way, I'm told, is so that you will have a car when you get there. Otherwise, you wouldn't drive, huh? Well, I have a change of plans for you. Here are two plane tickets for you. And when you arrive, husband, you better take care of these. You'll find yourself a car, a Plymouth, by the way, waiting for you at your disposal with our compliments. And also, we'd like you to be our guest at the hotel in Miami Beach. So thank you all for sharing these happy occasions with us.
All right. Now, did you ever notice the different ways people describe a headache? One person will say he has a pounding headache, another will say he has a splitting headache, while another one would say that his head is bursting. Well, to each his own. But the fact is that most headaches are due to one thing, tension. The kind that you can get on those bad days when everything seems to go wrong. And be your head pounding, splitting, or bursting, what you want is Bufferin for really fast pain relief. You see, Bufferin is the modern drug for a tension headache. It not only relieves headache pain, it also fights other effects of tension, such as tight nerves and a jittery stomach. And Bufferin goes to work with incredible speed. It's no wonder that doctors recommend Bufferin by name more than any other leading brand of pain remedy. So next time stress and strain give you headache pain, take my advice, do as I do. Take two Bufferin. Now may I welcome our next contestant, please. Will you come in, sir? Would you tell our panel, please, what your name is, sir, and where you're from?
My name is George Banakis, and I'm from Pensacola, Florida.
This is Mr. Banakis, and he is from Pensacola, Florida. Now, Mr. Banakis, if you will whisper your secret to me, we'll show it at the same time to the audience at home. Well, now, that in itself is pretty fascinating. But there's more to it. May we see? Thank you. Panel, the clue to Mr. Banakis' secret concerns something he did. We'll start the questioning with Bess, please.
George, this thing that you did you do it recently?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And was it a thing that appeared in the paper? Did we read about it in the newspaper?
I don't think you did, no.
It appeared in the local papers.
In the local paper. Yes. Mm-hmm. Was it some physical activity that you performed?
No.
No. Did it have...
Oh, now, Mr. Banakis, may I...
Oh, wait a minute.
May I fiddle with that answer for a little bit? She wanted to know if it was physical. I think while there was a great deal of mental activity involved, I think it was primarily a physical thing, wouldn't you say?
Well, yes.
Yes. Was there any mechanical device involved in this secret?
No.
Nothing.
All right, $20 down, $60 to go. We go, please, to Bill Cullen.
I think you established it was just some physical activity. Most of it was mental.
No, just the reverse. We said there must have been certainly some mental work
but
to it. But it was mainly a physical thing.
Did it, Mr. Banakis, require you to move from one place to another? Specifically, I mean, primarily?
Well, if you mean from location to location, I would say no. The answer was he had to move while doing it.
Right.
It was all pretty much done in one place, wasn't it?
That's right.
Did it help anyone, sir, aside from yourself?
I should think we could say it gave pleasure to other people, wouldn't you?
Well, I hope so.
Me, for one, I have gained some pleasure from it.
Even though you didn't know about it when it happened?
Even though I didn't know
about... Yeah, well, I assume, because you said it didn't get in these papers, but it might have gotten the local paper... That even though you did know Mr. Banakis was doing it, you got some pleasure from it.
I later derived some pleasure from this activity.
Might we all have then?
I think that you will.
Does it have anything to do with the holiday season?
Yes.
All right, there's 40 down, 40 to go. We go to Carol, please.
Is this... Would this physical thing, would you term it as being athletic?
No.
Are you an actor? Do you have an audience when you do this?
No.
No audience? I was going to ask you if you played Santa Claus or something.
He'd be pretty skinny Santa Claus. Things aren't that tough in the North Pole.
Oh, gee.
$60 gone, 20 to go. Henry Morgan, please.
What happened so far?
So far, he did something, and that's about all we know. It was
physical
in nature, and it gave pleasure. The end result gave pleasure.
And it was connected with Christmas.
Yes.
Was it something that starts out this way? For so many years, I have done thus and so.
No.
Just last year?
This year.
Don't let me kid you, Gary. I have no...
All right, $80 down. Panel, will you look directly upstage at a very handsome 10-foot Christmas tree? Beautiful. Mr. Banakis' secret is that he built this tree himself using over 200,000 toothpicks. I don't know how closely you can see it, but it is little clusters of toothpicks. The toothpicks are all dyed green and then have sparkly stuff put on top of them. Must have been a real job. How long did it take you to build this tree, sir?
About 7 weeks.
7 weeks in your spare time?
In my spare time, yes.
And what did you do with... Well, first of all, did you get an estimate on how many trees it takes to make 200,000 toothpicks?
Well, I understand that it took 3 trees, 65 years old, to make enough toothpicks to go into this tree.
And what strikes me as singularly appropriate about what he finally did with it, he's in the restaurant business, owns a place called the Trade Winds down in Pensacola. Driftwood, right?
Driftwood.
Down in Pensacola. Oh, boy. And he displayed this in the restaurant. And I think it's terribly appropriate in a restaurant, a tree made out of toothpicks.
Did everyone pick their teeth with it afterwards?
Not yet.
Not yet, but they probably will before the season's over. Yes, Henry?
Could I ask you, sir, without being overbearing the way I usually am, why did you do it?
I think that's a very good question.
Well, it didn't really start out to be a tree. I was going to make just some little ornaments to hang around, and they were stacked up on a table, and I got the idea that they would make a nice Christmas tree. So that's the way it was born.
This was kind of a mantle ornament that ran away with itself. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Banakis, for sharing some of that Christmas cheer with us. It's a lovely tree, really it is. We'll get Miss Faye out here again in just a moment. But first, have you ever noticed how much prettier a woman looks when she has pretty hair?
Such fun to be young. Fun to be grown up, too, especially if you know how to stay young gracefully. Her family adores her sunny appearance. The lively tone of her hair. Does she or doesn't she? Miss Clairol hair color looks so natural, only her hairdresser knows for sure. Yet just a few months ago, she made an important discovery while shopping for a new dress. Somehow, all the colors looked wrong. And suddenly she realized that her hair, which had always been her pride and glory, looked faded, dull. Yes, old. Now she uses Miss Clairol, and her hair color is young again. Fresh, sparkling, prettier than ever. Her hair in beautiful condition. And Miss Clairol really covers gray. So why grow old gracefully when you can stay young gracefully? Try Miss Clairol. You'll love it.
When I say we have a special guest, I know that you know it comes from the bottom of my heart. A young lady who was with us for quite a long while as a regular member of our I've Got a Secret panel. And here she is to give a lecture on how to walk safely on icy sidewalks, Miss Faye Emerson.
I haven't gotten used to them yet.
Well, just in case people didn't read about it in the papers as I did, what happened to you?
Well, Gary, I was not looking when I should have looked, and I hit a patch of ice in the big storm we had last week, and...
Down
I went and broke my ankle.
Well, I think this is so fancy at Christmas time, she's now wearing her Christmas stocking.
Isn't that wonderful? It's a Christmas stocking that Betty Chapin knit for me several years ago with my name on it and everything.
Says Faye and has a little...
It's over the cow.
Little bell up at the top, so she tells me. So, I will divest you of your crutches,
you.
If I may.
And if you will whisper your secret to me, we'll show it at the same time to our audience at home. Voila. Why would you do a thing like that?
Well, it does seem pretty silly. I have a very good reason, but I'd rather explain it later, if I may.
Well, it's none of my business right now.
Well, at the moment.
All right, fine. Panel, I'm going to have to ask you to put on your blindfolds. And, Henry, before you put yours on, we'd appreciate it if you would bring your chair and come out here and sit beside Miss Faye, if you will. You've always enjoyed that.
I always have, that's true.
Now, you put your blindfold on, too, Henry.
Sitting or standing, what?
Sitting, to begin with. All right, you ready? All right, no necking on the show now, please. All right, this concerns something Faye is going to do. And we'll start the questioning, I think, with, let's go with Bess Meyerson first.
Faye?
Yes, Bess.
By the way, did you know you were going to be on the show before this accident happened to you?
About the same time, Bess.
Oh, so in other words, you're not doing anything unusual that a person in your condition should not do or something like that.
Why, Bess Meyerson, whatever do you mean? It's unusual to do, but not necessarily.
I see.
My condition has nothing to do with it.
Now,
come on! Come on, you rat!
Come on, you rat! Who could you have been saying that to? Surely not Faye. Are you involving Henry in this? Is he doing more than just sitting there and holding
your
hand?
I'm just sitting, I'll tell you that.
He's just sitting here and being mean old Henry Morgan, as usual.
Mean old...
Is that up?
Oh. He's going to get hit, I just feel it.
I know, that's the way I feel.
Are you changing his appearance in any way?
Well, slightly.
Uh-huh.
Slightly.
I see. You know, he's been putting on a lot of weight lately.
$20 down, $60 to go, and we go, please, to, go, go.
Every time you get Henry up there, you do something. Are you improving him, Gary?
Oh, I bet I'm being improved.
Oh, poor Henry. You look very chic. Oh.
I think we're improving him, but then, you know, almost anything would.
You're changing his appearance, then?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Is it something...
Ho, ho, ho!
Oh, come on!
All right, $40 down, $40 to go, and so we go, please.
Are you putting him in another costume? Are you putting him into something other than the costume he wore here?
That costume he wore here was pretty.
Is he Santa Claus?
Now we go to Henry Morgan, please.
Bill?
Henry, you want to ask questions?
Yes. Yes, I'd like to ask a number of questions.
What's that in his stomach?
Ho, ho.
Take your blindfold off, Henry.
What for? I don't want to see
it. Well... Wait till you see the figure we built into it.
Oh, ho.
Can you stand up, Henry?
Sure, I can stand up. Oh, ho. Oh, ho.
Falling down, little nerd.
Oh, ho. I didn't do this. I didn't know anything about it.
There is a good.
Oh, ho.
Oh, oh. I
have no connect. I must make a public. Oh, oh.
There is a good and charitable reason behind all this. Will you listen while Miss Faye explains why she has done this?
Yes, and I have a very good reason.
Ho, ho.
I should have dressed him as Scrooge and I played Tiny Tim, but it didn't work out. No, I have a very good reason. I think it'll come as a very pleasant surprise to Henry.
Yeah?
I'm sure you've all been wondering what all these presents and toys and
I'm
gifts...
I'm sure that you all think I... Ho, ho.
presents and gifts are for you.
To give to someone.
They're for you to deliver to little children who have written to Santa Claus.
Good, good.
Now, as you know, why make the children miserable by this? Let's do something nice.
Well, as you all know, there are many kids each year who just, their parents simply can't afford. Santa Claus doesn't get around, so they write to Santa Claus in charge of the post office. Now, post offices all over the country keep this mail, and it's possible for you to go to your local post office, get some of these letters from Santa, and maybe see that Santa's wishes are fulfilled, such as we're going to do. Want to read just one letter, Faye?
Thank you.
Typical, we got this from the New York post
office. Dear Santa, I'm well and hope you are the same and enjoyed the year. Santa, Mother said the reason that you couldn't come last Christmas was you had to see so many little children you couldn't make it, but that you would try to bring us something this year. Even if you can't bring me anything, please try to help her get things for my little brothers and sisters. And then this little girl goes on to list, five, six, seven little brothers and sisters that she asked for. And we have a present here for that little child and all her brothers and sisters. And we have presents for all of them. Do we have time?
Oh, yes. We don't have time for any more of the letters. We have the specific presents that they asked for, which are going to be delivered tonight to them by Henry Morgan and many others of the members of our troop. We have the addresses. We're going to go around. We're going to deliver these gifts. Their parents have been notified that we're on our way. The children know nothing about it and will not see the toy until Christmas morning. The post offices all over the United States are doing the same thing. There are still 2 days left for people to go to the post office and pick up letters for children who otherwise wouldn't receive any. And by the way...
Is it nice to scare kids?
They won't even see you. They'll be in bed. Right, we would like to also thank the postmaster of New York, Mr. Robert Christenberry, who wants to remind you that if you have not mailed your out-of-town Christmas mail yet, please use airmail, because there are only 3 days left. Faye, thank you ever so much, my dear.
Oh, thank you, Gary.
We'll load up Santa's sack right now. See you next week. Merry Christmas. Goodbye.
I've Got a Secret will be brought to you next week at this time by Winston Cigarettes.
Right from the start, this cigarette is different. Winston. It's the filter cigarette that's pleasingly mild yet packed with flavor. And here's why. Up ahead of that modern filter, up front where good smoking just naturally begins, Winston and only Winston has Filter Blend, a special selection of fine, full-flavored tobaccos specially processed for filter smoking. No wonder Winston tastes good like a cigarette should. Next time, try Winston.
Dick Meyerson's Gown by Cameo. Bristol Myers also brings you Candid Camera. Consult your local listing for time and day. Got a Secret has been brought to you by Bristol Myers, makers of Buffrin for relief from headache pain, and by Miss Clairol, hair color so natural, only your hairdresser knows for sure. This is John Cannon speaking.